फोर्थ सेमेस्टर मैथमेटिक्स पेपर फोर अलजेब्रा यूनिट फोर पॉलीनोमियल रिंग्स लेक्चर सिक्स बाय डॉक्टर पीर हमलू एट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स एमवीएस गवर्नमेंट आर्ट्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज. टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग पॉलीनोमियल रिंग्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गोइंग टू डिस्कस पॉलीनोमियल रिंग्स. व्हाट इज पॉलीनोमियल? ए फंक्शन एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू ए एन एक्स पावर ऑफ एन ए एन माइनस वन एक्स पावर ऑफ एन माइनस वन प्लस ए वन एक्स प्लस ए नॉट ऑफ द फॉर्म इज कॉल्ड polynomial where a naught a1 a are constant and the polynomial is called finite polynomial. This is I am writing up to n minus nth degree. I am writing here, so this is a polynomial, finite polynomial. If to my function of the form a naught plus a1 x plus a2 x square plus up to an x power n plus up to so on, this is called infinite polynomial. Infinite for finite polynomial written as f of x equal to I equal to n a x power of n. Infinite polynomial written as I equal to infinite a x power of n. What is the degree of polynomial? If a not equal zero in this expression, then this degree of this polynomial is called n. Suppose if a n zero, a not equal zero, then the degree of this polynomial is called n minus one. If a n zero, a n minus one zero, up to so on, a n minus two zero, then a n minus two not equal zero, then degree of polynomial is n minus two. Similarly, we can write a n 0, a n minus 0 up to a 3 0. If a 2 not equal 0, the degree of polynomial is called 2. If all 0, if a 1 not equal 0, the degree of polynomial is 1. If all are 0 at a not equal 0, then degree of polynomial is 0. That means f of x equal to a naught is called constant polynomial. The degree of constant polynomial is called 0. What about 0? If f of x all are 0, then f of x equal to 0 is called 0 polynomial. And the degree of 0 polynomial is 0 or infinite. Leading coefficient. What is leading coefficient? If f of x equal to a naught plus a1 x plus a2 x square dias a n x power of n minus n no of the polynomial degree n, then a n not equal 0 is called, if the degree of polynomial this, if a not equal 0, this called leading coefficient. Example, f of x equal to 3 x power 5 power x square plus x plus 1, the degree of polynomial is 5, the 3 is called leading coefficient. This degree of is 1, polynomial is 1. F of x equal to 5, this constant polynomial degree is 0. If I take f of x equal to 0, that is 0 of polynomial, this degree of 0 polynomial is 0 or infinity. Addition of two polynomial. I am taking that f of x equal to an plus dash up to I equal to n x power of n, g of x equal to this. So if I write f of x to g of x, so can add constant terms, x terms and x square terms to dash. So this expression is called addition of two polynomial. If I instead of writing addition for finite polynomial, you can write infinite polynomial also. We can do addition of two polynomial. If I take infinite, infinite polynomial also. Example, f of x called x square plus 1. So g of x called x plus 1. If I add constant terms, so 1 plus 1 equal to 2. If I add x terms, we will get x. So if I add x square terms, we will get x square. The addition of two polynomial is this. Multiplication of two polynomial. I am taking f of x equal to and this expression and g of x equal to this expression. If I multiply, we will get this expression a naught b naught a naught b naught plus a naught b 1 n to dash dash dash. So if I write simply expression c naught plus c 1 x plus c 2 x square plus c k x power of n up to so on a n b n x power of m plus 1, where c k nothing but a naught plus b k, a naught b k plus a 1 b k minus 1 a 2 b k minus 2 dash dash a k minus 1 b 1 a k b naught. Ring of a polynomial over ring R. Let I am taking that R be a commutative ring, the set of all polynomial of ring R of x is equal to f of x, so a naught plus a1 x plus a2 x square plus z as a n x power of n plus ai belongs to R, n belongs to n. Here n belongs to nothing but it is an infinite polynomial, is the form a ring under addition and multiplication. This ring is called polynomial, ring of polynomial over ring R. It is denoted by R of x complex. So this my R of x polynomial is infinite polynomial. I am taking that R of x equal to this, so nothing but a finite while looking by finite polynomial, but n belongs to n, nothing but it is infinite polynomial. It is commutative ring with R complex. I want to show that this is commutative ring with R plus comma dot. Let R complex count is a commutative ring. I am taking this is, so R of x is this set of all infinite polynomial. F of x equal to like this, it is in the form I equal to 0 infinity, I power x power I, g of x equal to this, I am taking h of x equal to this. So f of x comma g of x comma h of x comma belongs to R of x. I am taking three polynomial in R of x. Closure property. I am taking f of x comma g of x belongs to s, and you want to show that f of x plus g of x belongs to this. What is f of x? F of nothing but this, and g of x nothing but this. If I add this term ai plus bi x power of I will get this ai plus belongs to r, and this expression belongs to r of x. It is satisfies closure property. Associate property. F of x plus g of x, you can replace h of x. F of x plus g of x, already we know that ai plus bi x power I, h of x nothing but this. So if I add this xi plus bi, xi gets common out. Ai plus bi x power, we can written as ai times of bi plus ci. So that is ai x power of I, this is bi plus ci x power of I. Nothing but f of x, and this nothing but g of x plus h of x. So therefore, f of x plus g of x plus h of x equal to f of x plus g of x into h of x for all f comma g comma which is r of x. So therefore, r of x satisfies associative property with respect to r2. Identity property, 0 belongs to 0, 0 of x equal to this expression being 0 into x power, 0 x power that as this is 0 into x power of I. I am adding f of x plus 0 of x. If I add this, we will get f of x. Similarly, if I add f of x plus 0 of x, we will get f of x only. Therefore, f of x satisfies identity property with respect to addition. Addition. Therefore, 0 of x is identity element in R of x. Inverse, ai belongs to R, minus ai belongs to R. That's why I am taking minus f of x equal to this expression. I am adding f of x minus f of x, so we will get 0 of x. So that means f of x plus minus f of x equal to 0. Similarly, you can take that minus f of x plus f of x is also 0. Therefore, f of x minus f of x equal to minus f of x plus f of x equal to 0 of x. For all f of x belongs to R of x. So therefore, f of x, so R of x satisfies the inverse property with respect to addition. And minus f of x is inverse of f of x. Abelian property, f of x plus g of x equal to, I am doing f I plus bi. Since R is abelian ring, we can written as bi plus bi plus bi, we can write as g of x plus f of x. So therefore, f of x plus g of x equal to g of x plus f of x for all f of x comma g of x belongs to r of x. So r of x satisfies abelian property with respect to addition. Therefore, r of x comma s is the abelian group. Next, I want to show that r of x comma dot is semigroup. For this, I want to verify that R of x satisfies abelian closure property, associative property with respect to dot 2. And then f of x equal to g of x belongs to R of x. If I multiply f of x to g of x, just now already we explained that ai, bi, if I multiply, we will get some ci expression. I mean, here I am writing di. Why? Okay, already why? Because already I am taking ci coefficient there in h of x. So that's why if I multiply, we will get a naught b1 x is thing, and this if I multiply, we will get a naught b naught plus a1 a naught b1 plus b1 a1 naught x like this. So it can be written as di x power of I belongs to R of x, so I equal to 0 to infinity, where di equal to a naught b naught plus a1 bi minus 1 a2 bi minus 2 data as this expression. Since R is a ring, this whole element belongs to this also belongs, di belongs to R of x, this expression belongs to R of x since di belongs to R of x. Therefore, R of x satisfies closure property with respect to dot 2. Associate property with respect to dot. Similarly, you can take that f of x, g of x, h of x belongs to R of x. I am considering this element f of x, g of x. If I multiply, we will get di x power of I, h of x equal to g of I. It is the form of this one polynomial, this one polynomial. Also, if we multiply, we will get some expression. So, this expression I am taking as ei x power I. Ei nothing but this expression. So, that means again I am considering g of x and h of x. We will get this expression g of x equal to x of equal to fi of x or I want to multiply f of x with through this, so we'll get g of x for I, where gi equal to this expression. Let gi equal to, I'm taking ai ci by government, so ei nothing but this expression ei equal to, I'm taking like this. So therefore, if I simplify all this, we'll get gi equal to this expression, and gi nothing but ei. That means ei x for I, h of x for I, both are same. So ei x power of I nothing but this, so gi x power of nothing but this. That means R of x satisfies associative property with respect to dot. Therefore, R of x comma dot is semigroup. Next, I want to verify that distributive law. Like one, f of x into g of x plus h of x equal to I equal to 0 to infinity ai x power of I. F of x plus g of x plus h of x nothing but this. So if I multiply, I am writing bi plus ci as h of x. So that equal to, if I multiply, we will get some expression mi x power of I, mi nothing but this a naught hi plus a1 hi minus 1 plus ai h naught. So that is but mi equal to this expression. If I multiply similarly, f of x into g of x, you can multiply f of x plus to f of x into g of x, we will get same expression. Therefore, f of x into g of x plus h of x equal to f of x into g of x plus h of x into, we will get this expression. Similarly, you can take the f of x plus g of x into h of x. we will satisfy this property f of x plus g of x h of x into equal to f of x plus h of x plus g of x into h of x. Therefore, r of x is comma plus comma dot is satisfied the distributive property. Therefore, it is satisfied all properties. You can say that r of x comma plus comma dot is a ring. It is a ring over ring or. For example, I am taking that let f of x equal p of x equal to 1 plus x minus x square. Taking that some q of x equal to this, so 2 plus x cube in z of x is a ring in a ring z of x. Then determine f of x plus p of x into p of x plus q of x and p of x into q of x. I am taking that z of x comma plus comma dot to be a ring of polynomial. P of x nothing but 1 plus x minus x square, q of x nothing but this. If I adding this, we will get p of x nothing but this and q of x nothing but this. That equal to 3 plus x plus 2x cube. P of x and q of x. P of x nothing but this expression 1 plus x minus x square, q of x nothing but if I multiply, we will get 2 into this expression. Though this is degree of polynomial is 5, right? Note. Over the ring, then r of x is a ring. R is integral domain, r of x is a integral domain. If r is field, r of x is also field. Let f of x comma r to non-zero polynomial defined over ring r, then f of x plus g of x not equal to 0, then degree of f of x plus g of x is less than equal to degree of f of x into comma degree of g of x. Okay, so degree of f of x plus g of x is less than equal to maximum of degree of f of x comma degree of g of x. If I after adding that multiplication f of x and g of x not equal to 0, then degree of f of x comma d of x is degree of f of x plus less than equal to degree of f of x plus degree of g of x. Practical problem 32. Let I am taking that f of x equal to 4x cube plus 2x square plus x plus 3 and g of x equal to this. So where f of x comma g of x plus z phi of x, compute the polynomial f of x plus g of x and f of x into g of x. Aim to compute the polynomial given expression and to compute the polynomial f of x into g of x and f of x into the principles. You can write polynomial, addition of two polynomial, multiplication of two polynomial and polynomial ring. Z phi of x equal to this notation, taking that f of x equal to this, ai belongs to z phi, n belongs to n. So z phi comma x plus phi comma multiplication for phi is a ring. So I am taking that this is also polynomial ring. F of x plus g of x I am considering. F of x plus g of I am adding, you will get 4 plus 3 equal to 7. 7 mod 4 plus 3 equal to, this power is x 3 power x power 4. 3 power x power 4. The coefficient of x power 3 is 4 plus 3 mod 5. 4 plus 3 mod 5 equal to, this is 4 plus 3 equal to 7. 7 mod 5 equal to 2. 2x cube. If I adding this coefficient of x square, 2 plus 3 equal to 5, 5 mod 5 equal to 0, 0 x square. If I add x square to go of x quotient, 1 plus 1 equal to 2x. So if I add constant of 3 plus 4 equal to 7, 7 mod 5 equal to 2. If I add this expression, we will get this. So similarly, you can multiply f of x to g of x. So you can multiply already all the terms. So then apply mod 5. So we will get f of x into g of x equal to, here multiply will f of x into g of x, 4 into 3 equal to how much? If I suppose, if I multiply the maximum terms, 4 into 3 equal to how much? 12. 12 into x power of 7. 12 x power of 7. 12 mod, you can apply mod 5. 12 mod 5 equal to how much? 2. That means the highest quotient is 2 x power of 7. Again, you can multiply x power of 6 terms. 2 into 3 equal to how much? 2 into 3 equal to 6. 6 into x power of 6. 6 mod 5 equal to 1. Again take that and multiply 4 into 3. 12 x power of 6. 12 x power of 6 nothing but 12 mod 5 equal to how much? 2. 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So you can this is 2 into 3 equal to 6 mod 1. 1 and 2 will get this expression is 6 power quotient is 2 power x power 6 and x power 6 1 term. So the finally we will get 2 x power of 6, 3 x power of 6 plus x power of 5 plus 2 x power of 6. So then if I multiply, we will get f of x and g of x equal to this. So that means the quotient means must be less than or equal to 5 only, 4. 1, it is lies between 0 to 4 only. It not exceed 4. If it exceed, we have to apply mod to that. Okay, result. Okay, if I take f of given f of x g of x, you can write simply f of x plus g of x and f of x into g of x. Practical problem 38. Let I am taking that f of x belonging to ZP of prove that if f of b equal to 0, then f of b equal to 0. You can prove that this expression what it has given. Polynomial principle, you can write polynomial rings and Fermat Lady theorem. So, and a is an integer, p is any prime, then you know that Fermat theorem a power of p, a mod p or a b power p equal to a mod p. So, b power p into this is b mod p, a power b mod equal to mod p. Let I am taking that zp comma plus p comma x power p be a ring. Zp of x comma plus p is a polynomial ring. And Fermat theorem, we know that f of b, already given that f of b equal to 0. F of b equal to 0, which implies by Fermat theorem, you can that f of b is congruent to f of b that equal to 0 mod p. By applying Fermat theorem only, this is why, because f of b 0 mod p, f of b nothing but 0, if I nothing but here apply f of b equal to 0 mod p. Already we know that a power p congruent to a mod p, and that means that f of b power p is congruent to f of b equal to a 0 mod p. That means f of b is congruent to 0 mod p, which implies f of b equal to f of b power p equal to 0. Okay, then show result can show that by using Fermat theorem we showed this expression. Okay, so next r of x equal to f of x plus a naught plus a1 x, this expression show that it is a commutative ring. That means already we show that this is a ring. Again we have to prove that commutative ring, we have to verify the commutative property. Okay, by using commutative law, that means you take that f of x into g of x equal to g of x into f of x. So that means already we shown this, you can do your own commutative property f of x into g of x. So, okay. So again from problem I'm doing here, f of x equal to this f I plus 4x plus 2x square plus 2x cube and g of x equal to 1 plus 4x square. Okay, define over ring Z6. Then sum and product of f of x to g of x. Okay, we have to find the sum and product of this. Let g of x a ring and f of x come this to f of x equal to this and g of x equal to this expression in z^6. Sorry, z of 6. Sum of this to f of x to g of x. I'm adding this. Okay, of adding quotients of constant terms, x terms, x square terms. If I add constant terms, what happen here? 5 plus 1 equal to 6. 6 mod y equal to 6. 6 mod 6 equal to 0. You have to add constant terms of x. 4 plus 4 equal to 8, 8 mod 6 equal to 6. Similarly, you can apply mod for adding the quotients of all terms. The sum will be get 2x. What is the degree of this f of x, g of x, right? So, we have to find, I am verifying that degree and as well as sum and product. For that, I am degree of f of x, g of x is 3. The product, similarly, just now we already explained, you can multiply all these things after getting coefficients. So you apply mod 6, so the final expression will get 5 and x square plus 3 x square 4 x square. The degree of how much the maximum theory is 5. The degree of f of g is 5. The evaluation of homomorphism. Let I am taking that f is a subfield of a field E. Okay, and f of x is polynomial ring defined over field F. If alpha belonging to E, f of x equal to a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus that as an f of x, then the mapping pi of alpha f of x to E is defined by pi of alpha f of x equal to pi of alpha a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus an x power of n, that equal to, I am substituting in place of x alpha a naught plus a1 alpha plus a2 alpha square plus an alpha, that equal to f alpha, is called the evaluation of homomorphism. That means the map, if I define like this, this type of evaluation is called evaluation of homomorphism. This clearly satisfies homomorphism properties. So zero of polynomial. How to define zero of polynomial? Let F be a subfield of F, epsilon E and f of x is ring of polynomial over field F. Alpha belongs to E and f of x equal to this expression of polynomial. If I define pi of alpha equal to the evaluation of homomorphism, if the evaluation homomorphism is equal to 0, then alpha is called 0 of polynomial in f of x. So, but suppose you can take that f is equal to e is equal to z7, that means I am taking that both are same field, alpha equal to z7 and pi of alpha z7 of x to z7 with the evaluation homomorphism alpha belong z7, then find pi 2 of x square plus 3 and pi naught of this expression. Pi 2 of x square plus 3, just substitute that pi x equal to here, 2 square plus 3 that equal to 4, 7. After getting 7 mod 7 equal to 0, therefore 0 is a 0 of this expression. You can take that again thing pi naught of, right? So this is f of x. So pi naught of f of x equal to pi 2 of f of x, nothing but f of 2. F of 2 equal to how much? You can substitute 2 equal to here, 2 plus 3 into 2. This is expression 2 equal to 0. Where it is? Okay, I can substitute here. 2 equal to f of 2 equal to substitute here 2 plus 3 into 2, 6 minus 4 plus 2x square. Apply after getting apply mod, we will get 0. Therefore, 2 is also a 0 of this polynomial. Suppose I am taking find all zeros in Z5 of this polynomial in Z5 of x. I am taking that what are the elements Z5 of x, Z5 equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. F of x equal to 2x plus x square plus 3x square plus x cube. F of x nothing but by evaluation of f naught of f of, I am verifying that whether 0 is 0 of this polynomial. For that, I am verifying f naught of f of x, phi naught of f of x, f of 0 that equal to, f of 0 equal to what happened, 0 plus 0 plus 0. That means 0 is the 0 of Z5 f of x in Z5 f of x. Phi 1 of f of x, not even f of 1. I find that 2 plus 1 plus 3 plus 1 equal 2. F of 1 not equal to 2 is not 0 of f of x in apply in Z5 f of x. Similarly, get it at phi 2 of f of x, that equal f of 2 equal to get 64 mod 5 equal to 4. F of 2 not equal to 0. 4 is not 0 of, 2 is not 0 of Z5 f of x. Similarly, can have 5-3. After getting that, we will 5-3 apply f of 3, f of 3 equal to 3, 4-3 that 9, mod 5 equal to 4, is also 3 is also not 0 of f of x. You can take that 4. If I apply f of 4 equal to 124, mod 5 equal to here, sorry. Okay, if I will get any value, 16 equal to 124, that equal to mod 5 equal to not equal to 0. Therefore, 0, 5 is, 4 is not 0 of f of x. The zeros of f of x are in Z5 only 0. 0 is the only 0 of x. This ends the lecture 6. So, thank you for watching this.